So there's a total of 10 reminders from me. So the first thing, if the question didn't specify, you should never make your own assumption. For example, if the question gives you this diagram, is this a straight line? Not necessary to be. So you have to read your question, read the sentence. If the question said ABC is a straight line, then yes, it is a straight line. Or if the question gives you some hints, give you some information, and from those information you can prove that this is a straight line, then only we can say this is a straight line. Or else, if the question didn't specify the drawing just like that, and there's no hints, no much information that could help you to prove that this is a straight line, you should never ever assume this as a straight line. It can be a straight line, or it cannot be a straight line. So let me give you more examples. For example, this. Is this an equilateral triangle? Not necessary to be. And this. Is A and B has different length? Not necessary to be. It looks like this, but there is still possibility that this is actually an equilateral triangle, but they just want to use the diagram to trick you. So don't make your own assumption by just looking at the diagram. You should go through every single word in the question. Then only you can make a conclusion, or is this a straight line like that. So this is the first thing. You should never ever make your own assumption unless the question specifies. The second reminder, before your exam started, the examiner will instruct you to flip through your papers to make sure you get a whole complete paper. So during this session, please check your paper properly. Because during this session, some of the students, they will just look at a question. They will try their best to look at a question and start thinking of what is the answer, what is the process, all that. But please, whenever they ask you to check your paper, please do it properly. Or else, if worse comes to worse, you get an incomplete paper. You can't imagine how many marks you're gonna lose because of that. The third reminder, check whether your question paper is stapled well. This happened on me during my SPM 2022. For my mathematics paper, the staple already came out. So I request politely to re-staple my paper. Remember to check it. So the fourth reminder, when you're reading the question, you should read both languages. Maybe the first time you go through the language that you prefer, and the second time you go through another language. Since we go Bahasa Melayu and English, Dwi Bahasa in that question paper, correct? So for every single question, for example, you can go through Bahasa Melayu first and quickly go through the English version as well. This is to prevent any misunderstanding. So this is the fourth reminder. The fifth reminder, when you are solving the question, please do it step by step. I don't want you to rush. Of course, I know that you want to go fast, but please go fast but steady, okay? Don't be too fast until you skip too many lines. This will increase the possibility of you making careless mistakes. So do it step by step. For example, this. And then for every single formula that you want to use it, you want to apply it into the question. Before using it, I strongly suggest you to go to the front page. There's a formula list given to you, right? Have a quick glance on the formula that you want to use to make sure you are using the correct formula. I know maybe you are very confident, but during exam, you are another you. You are under a different circumstances. You are under a different situation with high pressure. You are nervous. You are anxious. You are another you. Try your very best to go and check. Have a quick glance on the formula list given to you to make sure you are using the correct formula. So the fifth reminder, after you complete every single question, you should quickly look back to the question again to make sure you answer the question correctly. Because some questions, they will have special requirements. For example, give your answer in 2 decimal places. You have to round out your answer to the nearest degree. Give your answer in radian. Give your answer in percentage. For example, if the question is asking for probability, most probably our answer will be a fraction, right? Because that's normally how we give your answer in probability. But if they state, give your answer in percentage, then you should take the fraction times 100% to give your answer in percentage. So remember, after you complete every single question, look back to the question to make sure you hit every single special requirement that they ask. You should make it as your habit. But if you don't have enough time to make it as your habit, and you're afraid that you might forget to look back to the question after you complete it, then you can try to do this, which is you make a huge, obvious, super ugly mark on the special requirements like this. Use the pencil to draw all the circle, arrow, or use a pencil. So that the special requirement is so obvious until it's impossible for you to overlook it. So if you say, but then it's very ugly, I don't care because I want you to get the marks. So remember to look back to the question after you complete it and make a huge obvious circle on the special requirements. So the next reminder, when you are checking your answer, I strongly suggest you to use these three methods to check your answer. The first one, directly use your calculator. For example, for simultaneous equation, differentiation, integration, matrix, possibility, binomial, all this you can use your calculator to help you to get the answer straight away. So you can check your answer by just using the calculator. This will save your time and at the same time increase the, if this is the first method, use your calculator to check your answer. The second method, use the reverse thinking method. For example, this
question given fx equals to 2x plus 1, fgx equals to 9x plus 8, you have to find gx. To find gx, gx is located at the right hand side here of this fgx equation. So the first thing, we write down this formula here, fgx equals to 9x plus 8. So you just have to substitute gx into the equation of f. So what is the equation of f? 2x plus 1. So 2x plus 1 equals to 9x plus 8. So what is x here? X is gx now, correct? So now we put gx here. So you just have to solve this question like normally how you do it. So 2gx equals to 9, 8 plus 8 minus 1. Gx equals to 9x plus 7 over 2. So this will be your gx. So for answer checking, we can use the reverse thinking method here, which is you can substitute gx and fx into fgx, and then you see whether you get the same answer, 9x plus 8. So now we know fx equals to 2x plus 1, gx equals to 9x plus 7 over 2. So now we want to find fgx, which is equals to 2 what plus 1. So inside the bracket, we will put gx. Okay, and then 9x plus 7 plus 1, which is 9x plus 8. See, we got the same answer here. They are the same, which means this answer of gx is correct. So this is how you use the reverse thinking method. So I already show you more example on how you should check your answer by using your trial question in these two videos. So the video link are at the top right corner. Make sure you check it out afterwards.
And the third method to check your answer is you use a different method to solve that question and make sure you get the same answer. So this is how you should check your answer. Next reminder, after you have completed the whole paper, remember to quickly flip through the whole paper page by page to make sure you complete every single page, every single question. This is very important because sometimes during exam, when you're flipping the question booklet, sometimes the paper, they stick together. Then you might accidentally skip that two pages that are stick together. So remember, after you complete the whole paper, quickly flip through the paper to check whether you complete every single question, every single page. So the next reminder, please don't use your pencil to answer your question, except drawings lah. Drawings, you can use pencil. Other than drawings, make sure you use your pen to answer the question. And then no correction there. So the last reminder, listen. If you get stuck, if you can't solve a question, use a pencil to circle the question and straight away skip, proceed to the next question. Don't get stuck there and think wasting your time. You just proceed, and after you complete the whole paper, then only you go back to that question and think about what is the answer. Because first, if you get stuck there, it's time wasting. And second, there is possibility that you might get some idea from the following question. When you are doing the following question, maybe suddenly this concept triggers some memory in your brain, and then you will have idea on how to solve that question that you get stuck. And also if you proceed, your brain will still help you to process those information in the background. So when you look at the question after you solve the other questions, you might have new idea generated in your brain. So remember, when you get stuck, skip, proceed. Alright, so later on I will post some challenging trial questions, and then I will post my work solution for you as well, and I will post them on my TikTok account. So remember to go and check it out. So I already put a link of my TikTok account below in the comment section. I pinned the comment. Make sure you check it out afterwards. I will post it today. I remember to follow my TikTok account as well. And also remember to go and watch this Add Math series in my YouTube channel, because in this series I already show you some of the special trial questions that I find for you. And also I show you step by step how you should check your answer by using the answer checking method that I showed you just now. I already put a link of this playlist down there in the comment section. Make sure you check it out afterwards. And then the last thing, you can join my Telegram study group, and you could discuss with your peers, discuss with other students. If you have any question, you can just discuss with them. Although for now, the students in the group, I feel that they are a few shy to start a conversation, but whatever, you can be the one who start a conversation and ask for help. And then if you wish to share your own notes in the group, Mengalu-alukan. So remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow my TikTok account and my Instagram account. I'm The Sun. Have a nice day.